Hey buddies, Miss Puggy here, coming at you with another Borderlands 3 video. Today, I'm going to show you the best weapons and gear to use as Mohs against the upcoming raid boss. I'm going to keep the list short and simple. I could just list every single top tier weapon and why they're the best, but I want to just show you like a couple of weapons that is good for like most builds as Mohs and will be like old reliable and be able to get you to clear most content and most likely the raid boss as well. Let's get into the first weapon on the list. So the first weapon is, you know, Light Show. That is one of the best weapons in the game for Mohs. You know that it's very, very easy to use. If you've never used it, it's just one shot, shoots four bullets, and it just has great ammo efficiency. You just keep shooting and you don't run out of ammo too quickly. Of course, you want it consecutive hits. Light Show builds up consecutive hits very, very easily with the anointment. The raid boss, as we know, is going to be a Varkid, and Varkids usually have armor or flesh. So you want to try to get these weapons in either Incendiary or Corrosive, not Shock or anything like that. If you just focus on the two elements, you can switch and swap between the two in case you see that the raid boss does have lots of armored health bars or just lots of flesh health bars. Really depends, but we don't know as a community quite yet, so just play it safe, get corrosive, and fire. But let's move on to the next weapon, the Monarch. Very easy straight shooter. Once again, kind of like the Light Show, it has great ammo efficiency. Consecutive hits anointment is very, very good with the Monarch because you're able to get lots of shots out really, really quickly. There's not much to say about the Monarch itself, so let's just move on to the other weapon. Now, I put in the Plague Bearer because the Plague Bearer is always good to get second winds with or just dealing crazy amounts of damage really, really quickly. More than likely, we're going to see instances of the boss where it summons adds. So the Plague Bearer would be a great AoE to destroy the adds, assuming they spawn in a cluster, or to shoot the adds in case we ever go into fight for our life. And for a little bit of cheese, explain a little bit more later, we're going to be using the Unforgiven in case you ever want to use Rocketeer cheese. I'll explain that mechanic in case you guys aren't familiar with it. But let's move on to the other important things on the list. You will need to get a Old God with Fire and an Old God with Corrosive. What I'm going to recommend is either on action scale end of Fire or Corrosive. Once again, we're going in those two elements only. Or getting the after exiting Iron Bear kills increase Iron Bear's cooldown. Because if they summon adds, you'll be able to use Iron Bear more and more quickly. The more times you can use Iron Bears, the more chances you have in invulnerability. Since you get a little bit of invulnerability frames when you enter Iron Bear, that'll be very, very useful in case the raid boss has instant kill the mechanics or something that's going to deal crazy amounts of damage really, really quickly. Otherwise, you'll want to have plus ultra because it gives Iron Bear two times the amount of health, and that's crazy because Iron Bear has crazy amounts of health, so that's very, very useful in case you want that. Otherwise, we are using some stop gaps. We have a stop gap with action skill start. These are going to be very useful because in case you ever break your shield, you're going to be immune to damage for 5 seconds, and since we as a community don't know everything about the raid boss quite yet, having those 5 seconds of like peace and quiet, like trying to figure out what the boss is really doing to you, will be very, very useful. So that's a very great thing to have in case you ever feel like you're going to need to analyze the boss. Try to get a stopgap the first time you get into the boss. Otherwise, you could try a faulty star cheese, you know, the bloodletter faulty star running around with ties that bind. The mayhem modifier that links the mob to you is called boundary issues. I messed that up somehow. You could try that. I probably wouldn't recommend this the first time you try the raid boss because you're more than likely going to fight for your life. We don't know if the mayhem modifier will work properly against the Varkid boss, so that's kind of like a you don't have to get it, but I have it in case it works. I'm really interested to see if it will work, so I have that in my build. Now for Mohs, we just have two grenades that is very, very useful as really any character, but we're using it as Mohs because Cloning Mining Tracker gives us mad procs with our Vampyr, so we have on grenade throw and action skill and incendiary. If you guys don't know how to farm Cloning Mining Tracker, I would recommend just save quitting a bunch of times and farming the vending machine. That's the best way I've gotten it. Every single time I've gotten a Cloning Mining Tracker, it's shown vending machine. It's your best bet, in my opinion. Otherwise, you want to use Its Piss for obvious increased damage against raid boss. It's going to have a huge health pool, so we want to deal as much damage as possible. So the Its Piss damage multiplier would be very, very useful. I have a on throw for the extra damage, and while Iron Bear is active taking damage, throws it. That'll be very useful if you're using the Iron Bear base build as Mohs, because then you'll be able to throw your grenades and get a little bit extra damage on the boss. Now, the three main class mods I would recommend with jumping into the raid boss is a Flare, because it gives you tons and tons of damage. a Bloodletter in case you want to try keeping your shields as healthy as possible, and a Rocketeer because you could jump into the turret on the back and just cheese the boss by staying in the turret, since you won't take any damage as Mo's in the turret. You'll just have to worry about Iron Bear eventually going down. But Iron Bear seems to have tons and tons of HP anyways, so more than likely it won't drop as soon as you put it down. Those are pretty self-explanatory. You don't have to go too much into why you would need a flare. Now for the artifacts, if you're going consecutive hits build like I'm going to be using a Pearl because, you know, consecutive hits always needs a Pearl to deal the most amount of damage. Otherwise, you could try having, you know, like a Victory Rush. Any type of artifact is going to be fine. I would really recommend getting a Snowdrift of any kind as long as it's not a Deathless, because you will want health gating to benefit you from not dying immediately against the raid boss. Snowdrift basically, you know, lets you slide around. You'll probably need the extra movement speed because Borderlands seems to have like a hard on with giving its boss like movement based attacks so that you have to get out of the way with big bosses. So definitely get a Snowdrift of any kind if you don't have one already. I'm sure everyone there does already. Now let's go over some just general information you'll want to farm, maybe like specific anointments, depending on what build you're going in as Moe's against the raid boss. If you're trying to do a Rocketeer base Iron Bear build, you'll probably want to use an Unforgiven because the crit damage you get does multiply on the back of the turret. You'll probably want to get, after exiting Iron Bear, kills increase Iron Bear's cooldown rate by 30% just to, you know, keep Iron Bear up there as much as possible in case Rocketeer Iron Bear does go down. If you're planning on running a basic Iron Bear build where, you know, you're actually piling it and moving it around, once again, get a shield with kills increase action skill cooldown rate. With the grenade, you'll probably want a on throw automatically when getting damage as Iron Bear with its piss, or some type of cloning mind tracker or some type of thing that will hit the boss a lot of time with splash, because you want Vampire to keep your Iron Bear healthy as much as possible. I kind of mentioned it before, but once again, you'll want to get an action skill and fire or corrosive on either a shield or a grenade at the very least, optimally on a shield since you want to have the on throw bonus with grenades if you plan on doing any on foot modes. Otherwise, get action skill and on your grenades since you'll want to have on kill increased cooldown rate for Iron Bear. You want as much cooldown on Iron Bear because Iron Bear, as said before, is your get out of jail free card. The, you know, entering Iron Bear gives you a few seconds for vulnerability, and it does have a huge health pool, so you could enter and exit and, you know, have like maybe like 6 seconds of Iron Bear cooldown left since it refunds a huge portion as soon as you exit. So you could probably use a bunch of those cheese tactics to try to beat the raid boss as easily as possible. Now generally, try not to run any URAD based builds unless you're like really familiar with the boss, because at first you're probably going to need health gating to help you survive a lot of the attacks that are going to catch you off guard with the raid boss. The health gating will, you know, obviously keep you at a healthy amount and give you a few seconds of, oh crap, I need to heal with some type of grenade or go into Iron Bear for invulnerability. You could try a URAD build, but I really wouldn't recommend using any URAD stuff at the beginning of the release of the boss. Also, quick recommendation, it's kind of ironic because this build I'm using here does have what I don't want to have on my raid boss ready mode. You don't want any points in the Thid Red line, generally because you want to keep health gating as there as much as possible. You could, if you really did want Thin Red Line, like if you really, really want it, just only put 2 points. Make sure you don't have any class mods that put more than 2 points in the Thin Red Line. I say that because as soon as you have 3 or more points in the Thin Red Line, you don't get health gating anymore as Moe's. So try to keep that in mind when doing your Moe's builds. Don't use more than 2 Thin Red Lines until you're familiar with the boss, because you will need health gating to survive against this boss. Trust me, raid bosses are supposed to be incredibly hard. So don't try to be too cocky against the boss, but, you know, you do you, of course. If you plan on doing Mayhem 10, you'll probably want Postmortium, like, you know, basic Mayhem modifiers you use in every single build. The floor is lava, chain gang, big kick energy, you know, the easy ones. But, of course, if you want to fight the raid boss without any annoying Mayhem modifiers, go Mayhem 11. That's totally fine as well. Now, there's a nice little Google spreadsheet that shows you how to get every single weapon and, like, where to get it and which boss to kill or which specific enemy to kill, that I'm going to link in the comments and description down below if you guys are interested on how to get these specific items and weapons. I would go over how to get each every single weapon, but I feel like that would add unnecessary duration to this video. But if you guys are interested in how to get those particular items, just click the link down in the description or just Google search it on Loot Lemon. Very easy to find this type of information online now. I hope this guide is as helpful as I'm trying to make it be, and I hope this helps you guys enter into the raid boss with some found confidence, and hopefully it makes your first encounter with the boss a little bit easier. If you're interested in the build I've been using as B footage for this particular video, it's my Mohs Flare plus Light Show build. I'm going to link that in the description and comments as well with the spreadsheet and such. Otherwise, I hope you guys like, comment, subscribe, and I hope y'all have a great day. Bye-bye. And the last shall be first to immerse in a pass out heat, facing him up with a moxie melt till he woke up drowning in tchotchke hell. More in a cave with a torch on a wall than a window arrangement of porcelain dolls.